have made on countless occasions. I make these remarks because I think it is necessary for us to remind ourselves of what human beings have done, both to oppress and exploit other human beings and to address their living conditions and to make life worthwhile. Men and women all over the world, some leave nothing behind, not even their name. It would appear that they never lived at all. Others do leave something behind, the haunting memory of the evil deeds they committed against other human beings, various kinds of theft, robbery, malicious injury to property, denial of human rights, simply because people are of a different color to you, torture, imprisonment without trial, and political assassinations. Every time the names of such people are mentioned, even at the height of their power, with all the glittering symbols of power, they are like a grave, beautiful outside, rotten inside. Whenever their names are mentioned, feelings of contempt, of disgust, of revulsion, of hatred well up in our hearts. We regard them as the scum of the earth, as pieces of rats who are not fit to live. There is another second category of people who leave something behind. These are the men and women who have emerged in various parts of the world and who have chosen the world to be the betting ground for their efforts, the theater of their operations. Their task in life is one, that is to improve the living conditions of the people amongst whom they live, to make everybody feel that it is worthwhile to live, to fight questions like poverty, ignorance, disease, and want. They are the men and women who want to put sunshine in the hearts of the poorest of the poor. Their name lives beyond the grave. They are the men and women who, when their last day comes, we are able to say from the bottom of our heart, here lies a man or woman who has done his or her duty to country and people. Their names live beyond the grave. They become immortal.